can do everything that you gon' like. You're rich and famous, I'm living a life. Oh, pull up in that new thing. I'm swerving and hogging up both lanes. You know I'm in the mood. After I score, I'ma bring it to you. They're a free agent, I give them the boo. I'm with the crew who we bringing it to. We got no limit, yeah, we on the ride. We all gon' step, we all gon' ride. Say you gon' ride. Say you gon' step by me. Spin the slide. Say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Who gon' step, 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 step by me?
Every time I'ma step with the steppers, black and white bins looking like pepper. Flawless diamonds, yeah, I'm good under pressure. 400 racks tucked in the dresser. Blowing money fast like Big Meech. Thinking that they winning, big reach. They know I'm the best, I'm elite. I know when they hating is instant.
Say you gon' ride, say you gon' step by me. Spin the slide, say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Who gon' step, 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 step by me?
This is the NFL on EA Sports, and football has returned to America's finest city, San Diego, California. Straight ahead, we punch the second of two tickets to the AFC title game, and we've got a great one in store, as it'll be the Ravens of Virginia Beach taking on the Chargers of San Diego. For a berth in the AFC Championship game, off we go in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. And this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Oh, the first play of the game going to be intercepted. Racing to the end zone. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Charger TD. So a big defensive play there on the opening drive, no less, as they make the interception and bring it back to the score.
And I think that's a signal for how this defense wants to play. They want to be disruptive, and you know they're going to take some chances.
Well, sometimes it can burn you, but right there, it paid off. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Here comes the return from the very back of the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go-around.
And sometimes, Park...
Oh, right on the heels of the pick six, another ball intercepted. Sauce Gardner puts it on, and he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. It's certainly not how they envisioned the start to this one. You give up the touchdown, and they take a shot on the first play from scrimmage offensively, Charles, but it gets intercepted.
Yeah, instead of just trying to nibble and, you know, work your way downfield, they tried to take a nice little chunk there. It didn't pay off for them. Now the defense runs on the field, having already given up a touchdown. touchdown on the first drive, hoping to get their legs under them and slow them down.
And all those mistakes, they just seem magnified here in the playoffs. Second down and a little more than a yard here. Now it's Richardson. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. And it appears we have a Charger shaken up on that last play. Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. He stopped right around the 13. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. They're going to look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. A 13-yard touchdown run. And the Chargers have taken a two-touchdown lead now. Early on, they have all facets of the game working in tandem.
Yeah, you get the defensive touchdown early to give you the first score, and then your offense piggybacks on top of that and gets their own. And any coach we've ever talked to, we've had that conversation with prior to the game, they always say, you know, if we can score on defense or special teams, that gives us like a 95% chance of winning the game. I don't know if that number's correct, but it certainly does tend to play out that way, doesn't it?
It does. And he'll very wisely take a knee here as they'll bring this one out to the 25 on the touchback. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building.
There he goes, right side. Inside the 20. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. A great effort there. 75 yards.
And the Ravens are able to strike quickly here as they are in for six. Boy, I got to say, I don't know how he made it all the way to the end zone without going down. What a run.
Absolutely incredible that was, because defensively you're taught to break down, wrap up, but in this case he didn't really allow it, and really no one was able to slow him down enough for the extra help to get there. He just kept getting out of tackles all the way downfield and found the end zone.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They'll try and throw for it. And now the pressure gets there, and he goes down. So he couldn't get rid of the football, and that deficit stays right where it is. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away.
Now this is going to be returned from the back line of the end zone. And he's going to be taken down inside the 10 at about the 8-yard line.
Anytime you feel the kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
They'll start on the ground here on first down. And a short pickup here as he'll get across the 10 to the 11-yard line. A gain of three, second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in.
And that is not what you expect from a receiver of his caliber. Sometimes you get a little ahead of yourself. You don't look it in, and all of a sudden it's on the ground. A surprise to all.
And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line, it's a sack. Deron Payne in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that will lead to fourth down.
So from their own end zone here, this kicks away. It's fielded at the 45. It'll be a 47-yard punt with a net of 40 following a 7-yard return. And the Ravens set up well to begin their drive as it'll begin in enemy territory already. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
On second down, they'll run it here. And good pursuit yet again by the Chargers as they stuff him behind the line. A good chance this is four down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a 3rd and 3. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. Just a yard on the run there. That's going to bring us to a 4th down.
Don't forget knowing where the first down line was. His defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front. And a lot of times that is one-on-one. If you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They have more people to the football and snuffed out the play.
And I don't think he got there. He did not. They stop him a yard shy. Chargers in good field position to start out. 1st and 10 at the 39-yard line. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on 1st down.
Defensively, he has been a presence in their backfield in the first half. Had a sack earlier, and now he comes up with a big tackle for a loss.
2nd and 13. Throw left side, complete. That's Whitaker. Here now, 3rd and 1 yard. Now they'll change things up. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he will have the 1st down as he gets this to the 47. Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a 6-yard pickup on 3rd down. Right back to him on 1st down. And a good push up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. 18 big yards on that one, and a Charger first. They go play action here on 1st down. Rolling to his right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now 2nd down.
Offense was moving it a little bit. Had them back on their heels, but they earn a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
He's got his man. The kick unit on here for the Chargers as they will send this one away. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They trail early on the road in the playoffs. Not a great combination as they've got it 1st and 10. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. 2nd down. Here's a 2nd and 7. And this one is going to be off the mark. Too far out in front.
They'll put a check mark in the box where the defense coordinator was saying, how well can we stay with these receivers if we're in man coverage? Because he just did it on that one. Force the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder. move with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely. Frees up your guys elsewhere. And now the third down throw incomplete as well. That makes him now 0 for 2 here in the first quarter on third down conversions.
And now they'll look to their defense because they need them to step up so they don't fall further behind here in the early going.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. That'll go as a 42-yard punt, and they'll be aided by a loss of yardage on the return. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. The Charger drive about to get going. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated grooves. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways because you know they're both motivated, they both game planned for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Now that sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Now back to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. That's good for a first down. Here's a guy who went over 1,000 yards receiving in the regular season, and now he's got his first catch of the playoffs. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And all the way in for a Charger touchdown. A great play there. 61 yards. And the Chargers continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead. Extra point right down the middle, and the lead opens up now to 22 points. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They're forced to play catch-up early in this division round game as they search for a seat in the AFC Championship round. The throw right side is complete here on the first play of the drive. We are in for a good one as we're through one on EA Sports. Raven football here as we begin quarter number two, as they've got it with second down and less than a yard. And now they'll run it here off tackle. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. So that run play nullified by the holding call on the tight end.
Yeah, I just think he needs to get off the ball a lot quicker and get into the block a little bit more effectively. Then he doesn't have to reach and grab and try and hold on.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. And no move to get the offense off the field. Despite failing once, they're going to go again here on fourth down. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Kyle Hamilton picks it. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line.
Let's go now.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack to about the 26 here.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times, you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body.
Touchdown, Chargers! A great effort there. 26 yards. And the Chargers are able to widen their lead here in this first half. Now the try here for the point after. He gets it to go, and the lead swells, 35-6. The kick unit on here for the Chargers as they will send this one away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And they're going to start in a hole as he's brought down at the 11. And it appears we have a Charger shaken up on that last play. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Well, still early in this one, Charles, but the last time this offense was out there, they threw their first interception of the ball game. So trying to avoid repeating that mistake here on this drive.
And to put a positive spin on it, at least it happened in the first half and not in a close game in the fourth quarter. But you're absolutely right, partner. One of the last things this offensive quarterback wants to witness again in this game.
Kind of an obvious question, Charles, but anything you try to avoid after your first pick, or you say it's one interception, we're still in the first half, I'm going to do the same thing.
I think you want to avoid playing scared, you know, and put it into the mind of the quarterback that you've lost confidence in him. Make sure you get some throws that he's going to be able to complete, make him feel good about himself, and continue to run your offense.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
They suspected it was a power play up the middle coming at them. And boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
I would say it'd probably be a good idea for him to reintroduce himself to his receivers at the half because they're definitely on different wavelengths. But I also don't advocate waiting that long. Next series before you get out there. Hey, let's get together, guys. Let's get this thing moving.
And a quick throw here. That's complete. The offense stays put. They failed twice already in this first half, but they're going to go a third time here on fourth down. Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 at the 45. They'll start this drive out on the ground. Dances by him. Breaks the tackle. He's got room to run. 61 yards rushing for him now as he has been strong here in the first half of this divisional round matchup. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Looking to throw. Left side, it's complete. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. He'll drop to throw. And it's caught. Down at the 2. Broke through the first contact, but ultimately stopped short of the goal line. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He'll bite, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. This will cost him 11 yards there on the second and goal sack.
When you're this close to the goal line, you've got to expect pressure from the defense, so the ball's got to come out fast. Got to get out of his hands quicker.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
like what I see so far out of this defense, because they've been showing their best coverages on third down. So far, only allowed one conversion on a handful of attempts. One area of their game plan that they've executed to perfection.
So everything else has gone right in this first half. Kind of follows in a loop for their kicker, too, as he adds three more onto the lead.
Yeah, and the way that this one's gone, definitely not looking like he's going to have to worry too much about pressure kicks late in the game. He can go out there free and easy, just work on his form, and he knocked that one through.
And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone, as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They've got some stuff to build on from that last drive, because they moved the football, CD, and then they tried to go for it on fourth down, didn't convert, probably left a bitter taste in their mouths.
I would say so, and I think that they go out in this series determined for that not to happen again. In fact, they don't even want to get to a fourth down opportunity. They just want to make sure they get it done within the parameters that they've set for themselves. Run their offense, get it into the end zone. Yeah, I think.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Moving inside the 20. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Charger TD. Well, CD, we have seen it many times throughout the course of the season. This defense coming up large and snagging a big takeaway. But here they get not just the takeaway, 6 points as well.
And you just knew that for this team to advance, they have to get a big performance from this unit. And to this point, they've delivered.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. After the pick six, they go right back to the air. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete. I hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath, but those guys on the defensive side of the ball, they've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks like the people just leave the candy out at Halloween, and you take what...
And oh, my goodness, here's a fifth interception. Picked off by Jaquan Brisker inside the 20. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Charger TD. An excellent play there, CD, on the pick six. And I think were they a nickel? Did they have an extra DB out there?
Yeah, Brandon, I think they were in standard nickel, not the Buffalo, as teams like to call it, meaning three safeties for big nickel. They just wanted to take away the quarterback's throwing lanes, and that's exactly what they did, and came through with a big-time pick six.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. And the Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes. Calling a loss of five, a big sack to bring up third down. Out of the gun now on third down. 1:57 to go in this first half on EA Sports. Oh, had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going. They're going to try and throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And he is going to have a Ravens first down. And it is a big letdown there defensively. They somehow allowed to convert on fourth and long. Back to throw. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And now here is another interception.
picked off by Emmanuel Forbes. And the Chargers are going to have it here just past the 25.
The Charger drive about to get going. Still more than a minute to go, so there is time if they want to mount something here.
Not only time, but they have three timeouts at their disposal as well. So that changes everything that you're doing here. Without those timeouts, you can only work the sidelines hoping to get out of bounds. Here, the middle of the field is still available because you can call timeout and regroup.
Let's just call it what it is. This has been a flat-out struggle for this defense all game long. They've really had a hard time slowing them down. And while I'm not big on speeches and guys jumping up and down, they might need their team leader on defense to get in their face right now and light a fire under these guys. They've got to start playing better assignment football and start getting guys on the ground.
71 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. Second down and inches. Pressure comes and down he goes. A loss of three on the sack made by multiple defenders.
Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw.
Pass taken in by his big tight end.
And the Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. To throw now on first down. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there's not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
Got a man, and he hits him in stride. Now a timeout signal for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
And my goodness, another interception. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Go. They'll look to throw again. And this will be caught in the end zone for a Chargers touchdown.
Amon-Ra St. Brown
in the final seconds of the first half.
And the Chargers will extend their lead here just before halftime.
The call is to go for one and kick the extra point. And the route is on here in this first half.
Four seconds, all that remain here this first half as the kick gets away. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
They'll throw now on the final play. Catch is made by Metcalf. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. That's the name of the game, and we're back underway with the second half of this AFC divisional round. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Richardson to throw off play action.
And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee.
Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Back to throw. Here's Richardson.
And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes.
More than one defender there, and that's a loss of five on the sack.
This is a little hard for me to compute because I'm watching sack after sack happen, but somehow they're still behind in the game. I would expect all of this defensive pressure to translate to them taking a lead thus far.
And pressure coming, and they got him once again.
Taken down for the fifth time this game. Multiple defenders there to get him.
On is the Chargers punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away.
They're better than that.
Push it downfield, offense.
It's a 46-yard punt, two on the return. And the Ravens, they'll take over. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles. But I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlet.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Inside the 20. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. A big play there. His second touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Ravens are able to claw one back.
Elliott Good on the extra point. So they do get one score back, but still a long way to go here in the third quarter. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away.
This will be returned from deep in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. Still well in control of this ball game despite giving up that touchdown a moment ago. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down.
92 yards rushing for him now in the ball game as he is trying to will his guys for the championship round next weekend.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
Now Richardson is going to keep it running right.
Trying to keep those big legs churning, but he's going to go down in the backfield. It's a loss of four on the first down play. So a step in the wrong direction. Now they'll look to make amends on second and 14. He's got a man. That's caught. Left sideline. Touchdown. A great play there with his second touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Chargers extend their lead yet again.
Extra point attempt to follow here. PAT would extend their lead, but there is a flag on the play.
And that flag accepted.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield.
He will return this from deep in the end zone. And he's going to be brought down inside the five at the three.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
A nice-looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. A big play that time for the Ravens. 51 yards.
No surprise he was targeted on that play, because you and I both know quarterbacks like guys who can catch the ball, but they actually expect that. They love the guys who do something with it after the catch.
Yeah, impressive making him miss on that tackle attempt. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
It's funny, throughout the time that we've been together, when we talk with running backs about the ability to catch the ball, their eyes light up when they talk about open field and having one-on-one matchups, don't they?
Yeah, they do. And that's the reason why. What we just saw, shedding those tackles, and that's what they're used to doing.
It is, and it starts at the beginning of the play, one-on-one matchup with someone trying to cover them. But they also like those one-on-ones downfield after the catch when they're running with the ball. They think they're going to win those, too.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. Got a man, it's caught for a Ravens touchdown. DK Metcalf, 35 yards. And the Ravens are able to at least get one score back. So the Ravens will keep the offense on the field as they're going to go for two. They're going to try and run. And he will get into the end zone as the deficit moves from really bad to slightly less than really bad. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. Still comfortably on top, third quarter, as they start things here with a first and 10. And forget that 100-yard rushing game, at least for the moment, as he'll lose yardage here and fall back under the century mark for the game. On second down, it's Richardson to throw it. And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get forward progress. That'll be a safety. So a free kick situation forthcoming from the 20 as they'll punt this one away. This returnable for Kupp. They'll come out throwing here on first down. And his throw is incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
They'll get a yard, that's all, as they get him down at the 28.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Quick hitter here. It's complete. And they're going to get him down well short of the first, as he can only get this to the 30. They'll try and throw for it here. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. And the offense moving quickly to the line. And now an audible here into something else. They'll look to throw now on first down. That one tipped, and it's incomplete. But good hands there defensively. That's second down.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so they went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
Second and 10 here as we sit in the third quarter of this divisional round matchup. Now they'll run it on the toss. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there. And now fourth down.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There's pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. They're going to look to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Ravens go for it, but come up empty. And the Charger defense stands tall, and they get the football back. The Charger drive about to get going. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered 2 points on the safety. They don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs.
Sure.
just messes things up for you offensively. But now they've got to go ahead, take it, set it aside, and move forward.
Steps away. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side. And this is taken in at the five. Touchdown, Chargers. A great effort there. Saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Chargers will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the third. And now it's blocked. Picked up by the offense. This is a live ball. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but the other team doesn't get it. That's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
Well, this has been a tough one for them, Charles. They've struggled really on both sides of the football. And one thing that's really plagued them, the turnovers. They've had issues.
And got his man complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. One quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Jaquan Brisker. And the Chargers are going to get it back here just shy of the 20. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Play action. Now Richardson. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And this will be gathered up in the end zone. And that's a defensive touchdown. Once that ball was loose, the question was, would this be two or would it be six? It's six. The defense able to pounce on it.
And for the offense, the training didn't really kick in, did it? Once that ball comes loose, you've got to get on it, make sure that you recover it, or make sure you punch it out of the end zone. Anything but give it to the defense to score a touchdown.
They'll try and throw for it. That's caught. And he will get into the end zone as the deficit moves from really bad to slightly less than really bad. So a big play there. Not only the fumble return for the touchdown, then they get the two-point try. And, you know, for the defense, though, they were just over there sitting on the field. They had to rush out to try to defend that.
You know, it's funny. They actually practice situations that they call sudden change when the team turns it over. I guarantee you no one practices a fumble return for a touchdown like that, and now someone goes for two. Really good strategy by them putting them in that situation.
And this will not work out. The Chargers able to recover. The fourth quarter, it felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
A three-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. And they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground.
Just a yard there, so it brings up a tough third and 12.
Well, partner, Marvin, our number one stats guy, just handed me a little card that says he has 97 yards on the ground today. You think he's going to get the ball again?
I think so. Three away from that century mark, got to have it.
Yeah, and I think what they're going to call.
And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown. Chargers are drawing closer to a date in the AFC title game as they extend this fourth quarter lead. The extra point splits the uprights. And this one was over a while ago as they just piled onto that big lead. The kick unit on here for the Chargers as they will send this one away. This will be returned from deep in the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Their hopes of advancing past this divisional round hanging by a thread, if that, as they begin here with a first and 10 on the wrong side of the scoreboard. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Even with such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lapsed one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're going to have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything.
Now a second and 10. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Jaquan Brisker. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Charger TD. Well, what has been a fantastic game for this defense has been rough for this offense. And certainly a signal caller, Charles, that's thrown all these interceptions. Another one there, and this one taken all the way back for the score.
Nice little spot in the postgame highlights to show this rip of interceptions and great plays this group has made. They've been on it from snap one.
He will return this from deep in the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. Here's a handoff out of the gun. And a good pickup there. He gets about 6 up to midfield. They're going to hurry back to the line now. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 37. They'll drop to throw. And now here's another interception. And the Chargers are going to take over at their own 13-yard line. Yet another mistake after the interception there. And gosh, you look up at the scoreboard, they just got to be thinking this one cannot get over fast enough.
It certainly can't. And also what happens when you get this big of a deficit, you're supposed to make all the right throws, right? You're supposed to try and obviously get the ball to your own guys. But being down this big, you also take even more chances. And in this situation, that hasn't paid off for them at all.
On the other sideline, jubilation and laughter. Here's second and 10. Hands it off out of the gun. And a nice gain there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20. 103 yards rushing for him now as he goes over the century mark here in this divisional round matchup.
Hey, Chris.
And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. Down the sideline he goes. And he'll take this down the 40-yard line. A big gain there on third and long. 41 yards. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere.
Second and 10.
One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And again, he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that one, no gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on third down. Now it's Richardson. That is caught. Touchdown, Chargers. A great play there. 40 yards. And the Chargers continue to run up the score. They lead it big here in the fourth.
So, my man, another touchdown. They're looking like the number one seed that they earned throughout the year. Looking pretty dominant right now.
We knew the road to the Super Bowl would run right through this stadium. Somebody's going to have to come in here and beat these guys. Good luck. I don't think it's happening this weekend.
No, definitely not this weekend. And for anyone else out there, bring your game.
Buyer beware.
Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
We said it at halftime that they would need a nearly perfect second half to erase that deficit that they were facing, CD. But unfortunately, the second half has pretty much been a carbon copy of the first.
Yeah, that early lead was almost insurmountable the way their opponent was playing. And, partner, they do have some good news, though. This one is getting close to being over, and they can try and hit the reset button starting tomorrow.
It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Now back to throw. Over the middle, it's complete. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. And now they're in the hurry up. It's a gain of 10. And the Virginia field. He pushes through a would-be tackler to get about 3 yards, second down.
And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up from just across the midfield stripe. Here's second down at 7.
They'll look to throw here. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 35. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. On first down, they'll run it on the draw play. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete, and he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 21. Someone moved. Flag is out. That's going to be 5 yards.
And that'll drive coaches crazy. You work all week on dealing with loud crowds, on dealing with motion, and then you have a guy jump.
He'll drop to throw. And this is going to be intercepted.
And the Chargers are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20.
They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
A beautiful fake. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. And quickly, they get to the line. Now it looks like he'll throw here. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Up huge on the scoreboard, and they're still trying to add to their total. That shot doesn't connect, but I don't think it'll dissuade them from attempting another one.
Throwing again, it's Richardson on second down.
He's going to let it go again. gets into double coverage and intercepted. And the Ravens come up with a late turnover. It really mattered to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over.
So they stay alive in the NFL playoffs, move on to the conference championship, and do you think that the printing press is starting to get those t-shirts and hats ready, my friend?
They have to, Brandon. They have to be ready, because if you win, you've got to hand those out on the field right away. And just think about the pressure for the players now. Families are going to be talking about tickets to the Super Bowl.
She got superstition. I'm not waiting and hoping and wishing. I'm not stopping, I'm balling relentless. I'm a stepper, I'm standing on business. And the rumors, I'm